as Niall said on the screen, it does validate a lifetime worth of work. It's all about the song. Robert and I apparently hit the bullseye enough times to be noticed and to give importance to our career and to enjoy the fact that fans have embraced this music to the point of giving it life, perhaps longer than our own.
I understand that the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame was a group honor, but this one is an individual honor, and it's something that I never expected. I always wanted to write songs even before I knew that I could. And really all I want to do is make music and write songs. But having an opportunity to be here in the presence of greatness is
really,
it's absolutely psychedelic. We're both still writing,
we are
recording,
yes, we are
touring, and because it's all we know how to do.
we're just so lucky to be able to, you know, to enjoy this ride, put food on the table, putting smiles on faces all over the world 50 years later.
It's crazy.
In our case, the brass participation is a main character in the song. It's a lead line with its own hook, if you will. You take the horns out and there's empty spaces. Perhaps it was subconsciously job security. I don't know.
I always, when I was writing the song, knowing it was for Chicago, I knew that there needed to be a place to let these guys shine because they play, the three of them are amazing together. We'd write the songs, we'd rehearse the songs, we'd record the songs, go out on the road and play the songs, and then come back and start the whole process again.
yeah, the mill. In the old days, we were on the road over 300 days a year, so the songwriting happened on the road. Robert and I had suitcase pianos between Holiday Inn beds, and it was go, 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 go.
But it worked out okay, didn't it?
Yeah.